represent many things that you may have thought you couldn't do.
It was just incredibly exciting. It was such a feeling to know that you could actually walk over these coals, something that would paralyze you before, and that you could actually conquer it if you really wanted to.
It was like, my God, I can't believe it. If I have done this, I can do anything. It just makes you wonder just exactly what human beings can really do.
I'm sure that everyone gets something out of it. It may be something small, or in many cases it's something very large that turns people around, changes their whole life, makes them a better person.
These people are talking about the Firewalk experience and a seminar they will remember all of their lives. Welcome to Unlimited Power, the new science of personal achievement by Anthony Robbins, another in a series of sound ideas from Simon & Schuster. Anthony Robbins is internationally recognized for his work helping politicians, Olympic athletes, businessmen, and even children reach their peak potential. He is the author of the book Unlimited Power. This program focuses on Anthony Robbins' formula for acquiring the specific patterns of behavior you need to make positive changes in your life. You will hear portions of his well-known seminar, Three Steps to Personal Power. Anthony Robbins will also tell you about his own remarkable life story, how he developed his concept of personal power, and how you can use NLP, neuro-linguistic programming, as a tool to take charge of your life. Tony Robbins, getting a room full of people to walk across 2,000-degree coals is a pretty unusual way to teach a seminar. Tell us, why do you do that?
One of the first things I want to make clear is that the Firewalk seminar, Fear into Power, the Firewalk experience, is not designed to teach somebody to walk on fire. That's not the purpose of it. If it was, we would build a fire, and 5 minutes later, I'd take everybody out to walk. The only difference between someone being able to walk on fire and someone not being able to walk on fire is getting themselves to change their belief systems about what they're capable of doing, of what is possible for their life. So we use the Firewalk simply as a metaphor. The purpose of the seminar is to teach people a set of very specific skills about how they can break through fears and limitations. Because it's my personal belief that no matter what you want to accomplish or achieve in your life, part of what keeps you from attempting to do those things or really developing a strategy is your own fears. Fear of failure, fear of success, fear of rejection, fear of pain, fear of the unknown. And what we do in the seminar is teach people specific skills on how to break through that and develop their own personal power.
And now, let's join that seminar. Here's Anthony Robbins.
This is a communication seminar. Ah, tricked you. If I would have said, this is a communication seminar, how many of you would have shown up? Yeah, that's what I was afraid of. Two. Two instead of 300. Okay. The reason it's a communication seminar is because I believe that communication is the key to your life. In fact, you might want to start your notes with the following phrase. This is what this seminar is all about. Write down, the quality of my life is the quality of my communication. The quality of my life is the quality of my personal communication. Here's what I mean by this. In order to have any experience in life and know whether it's good or bad, you have to communicate with who? Yourself. See, the quality of your life is how you communicate to yourself. How many of you ever had a relationship where somebody maybe left you? Anybody had that experience? Anybody here? Now, when that person leaves, you have several ways to communicate to yourself. The quality of your experience will be determined how you communicate about that situation. You might say, I'm not good enough, so they left me. Or you might say, thank God they left, so they made room for somebody who's right for me. It all depends on the way you communicate to yourself. That'll determine how you feel, how you act, how you behave in your future. So to me, the quality of your life is the quality of your communication, number one, with whom?
Yourself.
And number two, with others. Communication with others is what we all want. We want a sense of connectedness. See, how many of you here would really like to make a major difference in the world? Can I see a show of hands? Okay. How many of you would like to lie on the beach and get tan? Does that cause a problem sometimes, right? Like, as part of you here working to make a difference in the world, the other part is going, no, I want a tan, right? And you've got this pole in between, right? And it doesn't really assist. How many of you out there would like to be totally financially independent? Can I see a show of hands? How many of you also feel like sometimes, in order to do that, it seemed like it took away from your sense of appreciation of others or your spirituality? Anybody have that experience ever? See? But do you have to give both those up? No, you can learn how to integrate them. You can have the best of both worlds. How many of you would love to have a...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.